Hi everyone, welcome to this module on OCI block volume clone and volume groups capabilities. Let's first look at the clone functionality and what it does. Clone allows copying an existing block volume to a new volume without needing to go through a backup and restore process. As you recall from the previous module, when you do a backup and restore, you are doing a point in time snapshot. The backup is going to the OCI object storage and then you restore from there. If you don't want to do that, you could use this clone capability. As you can see here, clone is a point in time, direct disk to disk, deep copy of an entire volume. So there is no going to the object storage. None of that is involved, right? It's directly in the data center, point in time, disk to disk, deep copy. Clone operation is immediate, right? Like backup also happens asynchronously, so you can continue using the volume as the backup is going on. But clone is very similar, right? It's immediate, but actual copying of data happens in the background, right? And can take, you can see some numbers here for it's very similar numbers to backup and restoration, slightly better numbers, right? For 1 terabyte backup would take, let's say, half an hour. A clone would take half that time, right? Because it's, again, you are not going to the OCI object storage service. You're just doing a direct disk to disk deep copy there. You could clone can be created in the same AD with no need of detaching the source volume. You can be using the clone, and you could just you're using the block volume and just clone it. Clones cannot be copied to another region, unlike block volume backups. One of the key advantages of backups is you could copy the backups to another region's clone. You could not do that, and there are different lifecycle states for the cloning process. As soon as the state changes from provisioning to available, typically happens within a few seconds, you could start using the clone. Clone and backup operations are mutually exclusive, which means that at any given time, you could run only one operation. You could not do both at the same time. Number of clones created simultaneously. If the source volume is attached, you can create one clone at a time. If the source volume is not attached, it's detached from the instance, you can create up to 10 clones from the same source volume simultaneously. Again, depending on the use cases, you might want to attach it or not attach it, keep it detached, and so you could create more clones if that's, you know, you have a requirement like that. There is also this feature called volume groups. Volume groups, what it does is you could group together block and boot volumes from multiple compartments across multiple compute instances and create this thing called a volume group. Now, why would you do that? The reason you would do that is in reality, as you're working through your applications, you will have many block volumes and many boot volumes, right? If you have to do a backup and cloning and management of those boot and block volumes, it becomes cumbersome to do it by one by one, right? So typically folks would write shell scripts and they would try to automate it, right? Using Terraform or write scripts. Now that's obviously a good way to automate the operations, but OCI provides this capability out of the box called volume groups, where you could do that, right? And in a much seamless manner. So using these volume groups, you can create the volume group backups and clones that are point in time and crash consistent. You could do a full incremental backup, as because this, again, the whole set of these volumes operate as sort of one volume. So you all the operations you could do with backups and cloning, you could do that using the volume groups. This is good for protection and lifecycle management of enterprise applications, which typically require multiple volumes across multiple compute instances to function effectively. And then there is no charge for using this feature. So with that, let me quickly jump to the console and show you some of these features in action. So first things first, if I come here, I see the block volumes. I could do clones here, right? So if I say create clone, I need to provide a name here. And as you can see here, the original volume was 100 gig, but I could actually go to a higher size clone, right? I could go to a 200 gig clone. This we talked about earlier when we were talking about how you do instance block volume resize, offline resize, right? So I could do that, right? I could create a clone here. Now for the same volume, if I want to do a backup right now, you can see that it's grayed out because backup and clone are mutually exclusive. You can only do one at a given point of time, right? So I cannot do that. The second thing I want to show you is if I click on this block volume, I could see here Probably it was the other block volume. I could see that the clone is created here, right? It's available right away. And we also did a backup earlier, so you could see that it's available. And as you can see here, it's attached, this volume is attached to an instance, so I could only create one clone at a time. If the volume was not attached to an instance, I could create more than one, I could create more than one clone at a time. So let me just quickly. Let me quickly show you a couple of other things. So if I click on this volume groups here, I could create a volume group in a pretty straightforward manner, right? So I would say this is my volume group one. Because I'm in a multi-AD region, I can see three different ADs, but if it's in a single AD region, you would only see one. And right now it's asking me to select the volumes. So I would select block volume one. I would also add block volume two. And let me add another boot volume. The auto scaling boot volume, right? Because these two volumes are attached to the instance, and this is my boot volume for the instance, right? So let's see, if I was running my application on this instance, I would consider these three sort of together, right? So as a unit. Now I get this, and you can see here, my volume group has two block volumes, and it has one boot volume, right? So first thing I could do here is I could create a backup. So I would say, you know, create a backup for my volume group, call it backup one, and just create here. And now you would see that the backup, you would see number of backups three, because there's a block volume, two block volumes, and one boot volumes. I could create a clone as well. And again, these are mutually exclusive, so it's sort of grayed out because I can only do one operation at a time. So hopefully this gives you a good idea of the cloning capability and volume groups, and how you could do backups and clones for volume groups. Thank you for watching this module. I hope that you found this useful. If you have time, please join me in the next module, where we'll talk a little bit about boot volumes. Thank you.